So here we'll discuss again in continuation with first video. Okay, with different bases, we'll see to multiply, right? So first we'll see with base 1000, as we have done all the varieties with base 100. Then we can see how we can convert this concept to near to base 200 or base 300 like that. Okay, so let's see now. Suppose now the given is 997 into 992, right? So 997 into 992, it is close to base 1000, right? It is close to base 1000. Okay, 997 into 992 is close to base 1000. What is the difference here? Minus 3, it is minus 8. Multiply this part, 24, multiply this part, 989. Okay, but again our rule comes back here, that number of zeros in the base will be equal to number of digits here, right? So here there are 3 zeros, so there should be 3 digits here. So what I'll do, I'll put 0. We have seen this concept in the last video also, right? What is the answer? Answer is 989024. Answer is, just simply attach these two parts, 989024, right? Okay, I hope it is clear. One more example, 998 into 989. Okay, again base should be chosen as 1000. It is close to 1000, both the numbers. Minus 2, minus 11. This part becomes 22. If you cross addition, this becomes again 989, right? Again same thing, this part two zeros, this part two digits, but whereas in the base there are 3 zeros. So as per the rule, number of zeros in the base will be equal to number of digits in this part, right? So you have to put a zero here. What is our answer? Our answer is 989022, correct? One more example, 1006 into 1013, okay? Again, both are close to base 1000, okay? 10 cube is the base 1000. Difference here is plus 6, difference here is plus 13. 13 into 6, 78, this part, 78, right? And here, 1006 plus 13, cross addition, it becomes 1019, right? Again, I need there are 3 zeros here, so I need 3 digits. So I have to put 10, to make it 3 digits, right? Now I can simply attach these two parts, it becomes 1019078. This is the answer. 1019078. This is the answer, right? I hope it is clear. Okay, now move to next. Now suppose the number here is, again we'll go one above 1000, one below 1000, okay, for that carryover concept, right? 1012 into 993. What is the number here? So again, both are close to base 1000, 10 cube, base 1000. So difference here is plus 12, difference here is minus 7. 12 into minus 7, minus 84, right? 1012 minus 7, cross addition will yield me 1005. This part minus 84, this part 1005. So now base is 1000, right? Now base is 1000. So in base 1, if I take 1 carry, 1 becomes 10. In base 100, if I take 1 carry, 1 becomes 100. Here base is 1000. In base 1000, if I take 1 carry, 1 will become 1000. If I take 1 carry to eliminate this negative sign, this 1 becomes 1000, right? So 1000 minus 84. 1000 minus 84 will be 916. This part, and this part is what? We have taken 1 carry from here. So 1 subtracted, it is left with 1004. So answer for this question is 1004, 916. It's a mistake prone question, right? Because many people do here 100 minus 84, 16, you write. No, 1004, 916. In base 10, that is our normal mathematics, we take 1 carry, it becomes 10. In base 100, we take 1 carry, it became 100. We saw in the last video. Here in base 1000, we take 1 carry, it becomes 1000, right? So, let's do one more example. Hope you are enjoying this, right? All these questions, all these concepts, I hope you are enjoying it. 1008 into 989, correct? Again, it is close to base 1000, difference plus 8. Difference minus 11, it becomes minus 88. You do cross addition, it becomes 997. 997. Again, same thing. If you take carry as 1 here, that 1 will become 1000. So here I am left with 997 minus 1. Here I am left with 996. And here 1 becomes 1000. 1000 minus 88. It is 912. So 996, 912. 996, 912. This is the answer for this question. Okay, I hope it is clear. Right, 996912 is the answer for this question, right? Now, so we again, it is similar to base 100. We can do all those, we can apply all those concepts here also, right? Now, let's move to a different base, right? If the numbers are, very important concept, this one I'm telling you. This will not find in books. This previous one, you may find in books, right? With big dot bit of concept. All such varieties are not written. With carryover sign, with not carryover sign, what will happen with negative sign exceeds 100, exceeds 200. All this will not find in a book, right? And this will not find in book, this concept which I'm telling you. Very important. If numbers are close to 200 or 300 or 400 like this, right? So what will happen now? So if the numbers are close to 200, 300, 400 like this, right? So what you will do in that case? What you will do in that case, right? Now, see here. Suppose I have to multiply 191 into 192. 191 into 192, right? 191 into 192. So now I can see that both the numbers are close to 200, right? But 200 is not a base. Is not a base, right? I have to convert, is not a base, I should say not a base in powers of 10. I am seeing only in powers of 10, right? So 200 is not a base in powers of 10, right? But what I can do, I can take it as temporary base. Temporary base, I can assume to be 200. So 200, I'll take a temporary base. Understand this very concept very carefully. 200 I'll take as a temporary base, right? Difference from here minus 9, difference from here minus 8, 9 into 8, minus 9 into minus 8, 72 this part, and 191 minus 8 is 183, right? Now, right now it is temporary base 200, but I have to convert it to any of the proper base, okay? Now, convert to any of the nearest proper base, right? What is nearest proper base here? 100. So nearest proper base is 100. So how to convert it to 100? This 200 you want to convert to 100, right? Understand this. This 200 you want to convert to 100. For that, this 183, you should double. It becomes 366. 200 base converts to 100 when this 183 is doubled, right? So if base is that, the concept basically is base here up to half. So if base saved half 200 to 100, this part there gets doubled. Only this part gets doubled, right? This part becomes 366. This part is 72. So our answer is same. Our answer is 366.72. You can check in your calculator, right? Always you can check. So these are the very, very good concepts, right? Understand this. When base have to convert to 100, so when your base becomes half, this becomes double, it balances. Base becomes half, this becomes double, it balances, right? Now, wait. I'll make you understand this one more problem, right? See, 188 into 193, okay? Again, temporary base, I'll take it as 200. It is a temporary base. Temporary base, right? Difference is minus 12, difference is minus 7. Fine. Minus 12 into minus 7, 84. Cross addition will give me 181. Right. Now, this 200, I need to convert to 100. For this, 181 needs to be doubled. So, 181 needs to be doubled. It becomes how much? It becomes 362. 181 double is 362. And this part is 84. Simply write this as 84. What is the answer? Answer is 36284. Answer is 36284. 188 into 193. What is the answer? Answer is 36284. Correct? I hope it is clear. Right. So first, 200 is not a base. So take as a temporary base 200 and now convert to any of the proper nearest proper base. So for 200, nearest base is 100, right? So multiple of 100. That's why, right? You can't convert it to 1000 as simple as this. So you have to convert it to 100, right? Same will do for 300 also, but we'll see for all the varieties of 200 now. Okay. So 188 into 193, it becomes 36284, right? Okay, fine. Now let's move to next question. Again, suppose I take here 186 into 189. Close to, again, I'll take temporary base as 200 here. Close to 200, difference minus 14, difference minus 11. Minus 14 to minus 11, 154, this part, right? 186 minus 11. Cross this, do this, cross this one. It becomes addition, it becomes 175, right? Now, again, I have to convert this 200 to, first you don't write. I know you remember this rule that here there are two zeros, there will be two digits only. But I can't, this is right now, this term right now, this term right now, right, I should write here. Right now, it is base 200. Right now, base is 200. So I can't do any operation, right? I can't do this carryover and all, okay? Because it works only in base powers of 10. Powers of 10, 10, 10 square, 10 cube, like that, right? So I can't operate in base 200, right? So what I'll do? First, I'll convert this 200 to 100. So 200 to 100 is converted how? This part being doubled, right? This becomes 350. This is 350. This is 154. Now it is fine. Now it is, since two zeros here, you need to be two digits here. You can take this one. You can take this one here. You can take this one here. It becomes what? It becomes 351.54. 351.54 is the answer, right? Amazing concept, right? I hope it did. Like many of you, I think almost all of you would not have known this concept, right? Very, very good concept. Okay. Now we can put all the varieties here, right? Again, same thing. We can put all the varieties. Let's move to above 200, and then we'll move to one number below 200, one number above 200 to complete all the variety. So let's say 212 into 217, right? This is a number. Again, I'll take temporary base as 200. Difference plus 12, difference plus 17. 17 into 12, 204. 17 to 10, 170. 17 to 2, 34. So 170 plus 34, 204. Do it mentally, right? This part. Now addition, 212, to anyone cross addition, it becomes 229. 212 plus 17, 229, right? Now, here there are first what we'll do, well, this is like temporary base 200. I'll convert it to 100. 200 is converted to 100 by multiplying this part by 2. It becomes 458. This is 458. This is 204. This 2 will come here, obviously. It becomes 460. And we have to 04 here, 04. What is the answer? Answer is 46,004. That is the answer. Correct. So I hope you're getting it right. Simply 229204. But first, I know that there are two zeros here, and I need to have two digits, but I can't operate in base 200. That's wrong, right? I have assumed a temporary base as 200. I can operate only in our normal base. Like, what is normal basis? 10 power 1, 10 square, 10 cube. This is a normal basis, right? I have to first convert and then operate. After doubling, this base becomes 100. Now we can do a normal operation, whatever we wish to. What is the answer for this question? Answer for this question is 46,004. Correct? 219. Into 212. Okay, 219 into 212, right? Can do this one also. Difference, again, assume temporary base as 200. Difference plus 19, difference plus 12. 12 into 19. So, or 19 into 12. 19 to 10, 190. 19 to 2, 38. 190 plus 38, 228. This part becomes 228. If you do cross addition, it becomes 231. Convert this 200 to base 100. Just multiply, double this part. It becomes 462. 228. Now, since there are two zeros here, there will be two digits. This 2 will come here. It becomes 46428. This is the answer for this question. 46428. 462 comes here. It becomes 464. We're left with 28 this part. 46428. One last variety in this. How to move like one number below 200, one number above 200. How to tackle with that, those kind of problems, right? See. 213 into 196. Okay, again, I'll assume temporary base as 200. Difference is plus 13, difference is minus 4. Correct. 13 into minus 4 becomes minus 52. If you do cross addition, it becomes 209. Anyone cross addition becomes 209, right? Now, again, I told you, right? This confusion will be in mind. Okay, should I take one carry? One carry becomes 100 or 200? No. I should only operate in base 100. I can't operate in base 200. Base 200 is not a base. It's an assumed temporary base, right? It's an assumed temporary base. I can't operate in base 200. As simple as this, right? So that means first what I need to do, first this 200 needs to be converted to 100. So this, how to do it? This part becomes doubled. This part becomes 418 and then minus 52. Now it has been base 100. Now it's normal calculation. Now I can do it my way, right? What I should do? In base 100, I should give one carry. One carry should become 100. So that means one carry becomes, this part is left is 417. And 100 minus 52 becomes 48. So it is 417.48. 417.48. This is the answer for this question. 417.48. Correct. So first, always convert, before doing any operation, convert it to base 100. How to convert to base 100? This part being doubled. Okay. 412 minus 52. 417.58. You take one carry. Now base is 100. Now base is not 200, right? Till here, base is 200. Now base is 100, right? Till here, base is 200. Now base is 100. So 417, 100 minus 52 becomes 48. 41,748 is the answer for this question. Okay, one more we'll do. Same variety. Okay, so now we are thorough with this concept. So we can directly apply this concept to all the bases now, right? So we are thorough with this concept. All this concept will remain same. Even if the base is changed, right? For example, see here. If I write 291 into 308, should be quite easy now, right? We know that. What we know is now, both the numbers are near to 300. So I'll take 300 as my temporary base. What is the difference here? Minus 9. What is the difference here? Plus 8. We multiply, we get minus 72. Okay? And if we do this cross addition here, we get 299. Correct. Now this 299 is in base, obviously right now it is in base 300. We have to convert to base 100. So 300 to base 100, we have to multiply it 3 times. It becomes 1/3. I told you, it becomes 1/3. So balancing, multiply it 3 times. If it was 200, 200 to 100, it becomes half. You have to double it for balancing. It becomes 1/3. You have to multiply by 3. Multiply by 3. So it's simply very easy, right? 300 into 3 is 900. So 299 into 3 is how much? 897. Just subtract 3. Okay, 897. And now it is minus 72. So now it is converted to base 100. And now general rule of base 100 will apply. General rule, right? Like suppose we take one carry for eliminating this negative sign. So one carry, one becomes 100. So it becomes 896, this part. We have taken one carry, this becomes 896. And 100 minus 72 will become 28. So 896, 28 is the answer for this question. Correct. To any base I can apply. To any base, right? See, suppose I can take one example like 63 into 71. Okay, 63 into 71, right? So now, we can, since both are near to base 60, both are near to 60 or near to 70, right? So what I can do here is, if both are near to 60 or 70, so suppose I can assume any one base. Suppose I assume base to be 60. I assume temporary base as 60 now, right? Temporary base as 60. Difference plus 3, difference plus 11. This part becomes 33. Multiplying this part becomes cross addition 74. Now it is in base 60. I have to convert to any proper base, right? So 60 can be converted to 10. It can't be converted to 100, right? It's a multiple of 10. So it have to convert it to 10. To convert to 10, it becomes 1/6. This part multiplied by 6 times. 74 into 6 is how much? 70 into 6, 420. 4 into 6, 24. 420 plus 24, 444. This part is 33. But here in base it is 10. Here there are 2 digits. That means I have to take this 1 digit here. What is the answer? Answer will be 44 plus 3, 47. And this 3 is left here. So 473. So answer is 473. Right. So see how we can extend this concept to anything, right? So whenever number is close to whenever numbers are close, right? Close means difference of 17, difference of 30, we'll always do, right? Difference of 30 will always do. We have done it, right? That means I can easily do 119 into 88. So difference of 31 is here. So numbers are relatively close, right? Difference of 30, difference of 40 can be easily managed by this base funda. Can do it very fastly by this base funda. Correct. So I hope this part is clear to you. This everything in this part, all the base kind of multiplication we have done, every variety we have done, both negative, this part both negative, both positive, difference little bit big in negative part, difference little bit big in the positive part, one positive, one negative, carry below 100, carry above 100, carry above 200, all the varieties we have seen in these last two videos of multiplication, right? So if this, I hope this is, that should be very clear to you. Okay. Now in the further videos, we'll see how we should carry this multiplication funda. Okay. To other means based on doing squaring and all, right. But this is all for base multiplication by base method. Okay. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.